It is Country Viewpoint here on Flow FM, and it's time for us now to have a look at what's been going on in the wool markets through the week. A man who's followed them closely, as he always does, Stephen Reed from Michell Wool, joins me on the line. Stephen, how are you, mate?
Excellent, Jason. And yourself?
Very well, thank you. Been an interesting week again in the wool markets, albeit probably a little, less dramatic than we've seen in the past. Is that a fair thing to say?
Well, it is. And I, the reminiscent terms from when I was growing up, it's a very humdrum week. Indicators hardly changed. Fair bit of wool put up. Most of it sold. So, very, very uneventful, which is probably not a bad thing for the wool market, given what's been going on for the last 18 months.
No doubt about that. All right, well, let's have a look at those auctions. What was put up? What sold? How did it go?
Well, we were expecting 48,500 bales. A couple of thousand bales were pulled out before the sale, so only 46,500 got offered, and 42 was sold. So the pass-in rate was down to 9.3%. So if you look at the yearly average, that's a pretty good clearance. And it was down 3.5% on the previous week, but still a very, very good clearance. And even with that amount of wool on behalf of growers turned into cash, the indicator actually in Aussie dollars went up 4 cents to close at 13.10.
The buying has come from one major centre, as it traditionally does, but they've even stepped up a bit more of recent times. So China is just buying basically everything we can put up at the moment.
Pretty much, Jason. And you did right. You can use that term. We've found a basis. And you look at bonds overnight and oil prices. Who knows what a basis is anymore? Mm. But we seem to have had a stable wool price, but it is all China. And there is a real expectation amongst the Chinese trade that their rollout of the vaccine is great. We're going to have consumers with pent-up demand who can't travel but want to spend things to make them feel good, and wool apparel will be amongst that. So their big sales are August, September, October, leading into their winter. If you look at the supply chain, they've really got to get amongst getting greasy wool right now. So they're into it. We've seen a little bit of green shoots coming out of Europe, but every day is a different day over there. And noticeable, a lot of our traditional customers who buy processed wool might take two or three containers of a given type. Now they take half a container. So you can see that their volumes are well, well down. Some of the Italian processing plants are taking next week off, simply not enough orders to go on. And you can see a trend more towards casual and knitwear, performance wool and against the skin, and certainly away from suitings. So there's some themes which we can pick up. But from a grower's perspective, it looks good. And as long as China does get out there and buy apparel in September, October, it should be pretty exciting.
Excellent. All right, well, let's look ahead. Are we expecting to see another humdrum week on the markets? What's going to be put up in auction, and are you expecting most of it to get sold again?
No, I think so. Next week is at this stage rostered at nearly 49.8, so nearly 50,000 bales, which is obviously up on what was cleared this week. History has shown us that over the weekend, I don't know why people do it, but they'll pull 2,000 or 3,000 bales out. So I suspect next week will be much the same as this week. Dollar's looking a little bit softer. Yeah, I would have thought a clearance probably 90%, and unchanged market is what we should see.
Always great catching up for a chat. Enjoy the long weekend. You got plans for the long weekend?
Yep, I'll be working on the farm, Jason. So a nice break from following the price of wool.
Fair enough. Well, we'll let you get back to that, and good to chat. We'll do it again next week.
Excellent. Appreciate your interest, mate. Ciao.